My name is Jimena and I'm going to present my third excellence project about amniotic egg. First of all, how to identify amniotic eggs. Amniotic eggs are surrounded by a hard outer porous shell that allows gas exchange and protects the embryo from pathogens, predators, bacteria, and rhino. Here you can see a photo of amniotic eggs that as you can see they have a hard porous shell. And this is a photo of non-amniotic eggs that they don't have it. Birds, reptiles, and some mammals called monitor shrimps lay amniotic eggs. Other oviparous, such as fish and amphibians, lay non-amniotic eggs. They must be laid in water or in humid areas, otherwise they can't survive. Amniotic egg creates a watery environment. Inside the shell, there are four sacs. The chorion that allows gas exchange from the eggshell to the embryo and from the embryo to the eggshell. The allantois that also allows gas exchange and contains waste. The amnion that is a membrane that contains the amniotic fluid and protects the embryo. This is why these eggs are called amniotic eggs. And the yolk sac that contains the nutrients that the embryo needs. A main advantage of non-amniotic egg over non-egg. Amniotic egg over non-amniotic egg. Amniotic eggs, they can be laid nearly, almost on dry land without drying up because the shell creates a watery environment that protects the embryo for pathogens, predators, damage, etc. And they have a complex structure. The non-amniotic eggs, they can be only laid in humid areas or in water, and they have a simpler structure. Let's find out more about amniotic egg in my laboratory through an experiment. To conduct this experiment, we need vinegar, chicken's egg, dish, forceps, and a camera. This experiment is divided into three steps. The first step is to observe the white and the yolk. The second step is to observe the shell. And the third step is to explain what happens if we put an egg inside vinegar during 24 hours. The first step, observing the white and the yolk. The white is known as the albumin. It's a transparent, mucous, jelly-like substance. The composition, it has water and proteins. The yolk it can be orange or yellow. The color depends on the chicken's feeding. And the composition, it has less water than the white, more proteins than the white, iron, fats, minerals, and vitamins. The white and the yolk in relation to the embryo. The albumin provides water and support and protection the embryo, and the yolk provides nutrients to the embryo. More about the white. In the white, there are two layers, the thick albumin and the thin albumin. The thick albumin is nearest to the yolk and it expresses less than the thin albumin, and the thin albumin it is nearest to the eggshell and it expresses easily because it is less thick. The chalaza. The chalaza is a twist strand that holds the yolk and the embryo in the right position. Here you can see a photo of my egg in the experiment, and prominent chalaza shows freshness. In the yolk, we can find two important parts, the vitelline membrane and the germinal disc. The vitelline membrane is a transparent membrane that protects the yolk. And the germinal disc is a small circular spot where the embryo develops. Here you can see a photo of the germinal disc, also called blastoderm, and is where the embryo develops. And the chalaza that holds the embryo and the yolk in the right position. Let's continue with the second step, observing the shell. The eggshell is the outer hard covering. Is rhiny, it can be yellow and white, and it is composed of calcium carbonate, protects the egg and the embryo for pathogens, predators, damage, etc. And it is porous and semi-permeable. The eggshell structure outside the shell, and we can find the cuticle. Inside the shell, we can find the inner and the outer membranes, and the air shell is between these two membranes. Here you can see a magnified images of pictures, eggshell, and the inner and the outer shell membranes. Trying to separate the cell membranes. This is a photo of me trying to separate the cell membranes using forceps. It was very difficult because it breaks, but using vinegar it was very simple. And you can see it in the third experiment, in the third part of the experiment. The air cell, as I said before, it is located in between all the two cell membranes, and it is located in the wide end of the egg. The air cell provides to the embryo air when the embryo hatch and it's going to breathe on its own. And as you can see in this photo, the air cell grows as an egg. The eggshell is porous. It is covered by thousands of pores. The pores allow gas exchange. Oxygen enters through the pores, and carbon dioxide and water vapor is expelled through the pores. Finally, the third step, explain what happens when we put an egg inside vinegar during 24 hours. I have used the whole egg and the eggshell. The eggshell is mostly composed of calcium carbonate, and the vinegar contains acetic acid. When calcium carbonate comes in contact with acetic acid, a chemical reaction happens. Let's see what occurs. In the first minutes of the experiment, a lot of bubbles covers the egg and rises up to the top of the glass. Why is this? The acetic acid dissolves the calcium carbonate, releasing carbon dioxide in the form of bubbles. The carbon dioxide releases continuously during all the process until the calcium carbonate is gone. After 24 hours, the acetic acid dissolves all the calcium carbonate and the hard shell disappears. Only that remains is the two membranes. It seems one, but they are the two membranes that form the eggshell. After 24 hours, the whole egg is soft, like rubber, and is translucent because the eggshell disappears. What remains is the corium, as you can see in this photo of my experiment. This is a picture of the evolution of the experiment. In the first picture, you can see that the egg is covered with bubbles because the acetic acid dissolves the calcium carbonate, and then the final photo, you can see that the egg is like rubber, and then the eggshell disappears. This is a photo of another view of the experiment, and this is my bibliography. And that's all. I hope you find it interesting.